Now, again, as I said, during the symptoms, the management of the kidney stones depends on the location. Okay, the location being in the kidneys. Now, as you know that there is the kidney, there is the tube, the tube which communicates with the bladder. Now, if the stone is in the kidney, that is the uppermost portion of the genitourinary tract. Now, we have got three modalities of treatment of kidney stones when the stone is in the kidney. Now, the first being the ESWL, which is extracorporeal shockwave lithotripsy. The second modality being the RIRS, which is the retrograde intrarenal surgery. And the third being the PCNL, that is the percutaneous nephrolithotomy. Now, when do you offer these modalities of treatment to the patient, and how do these modalities work? Now, ESWL, as I said, that is extracorporeal shockwave lithotripsy, can be used in patients when the stone is in the kidney and is of a size less than a centimeter, that is less than 1 centimeter. Now, what is this ESWL? It is a daycare procedure wherein the patient goes to the center where this facility is available, and there are shock waves which are being transmitted to the kidneys from external source. So the patient is not anesthetized, the patient is not admitted. So there are external shock waves which are transmitted to the kidneys under sort of local anesthesia. And these shock waves will fragment the stones. Now, once these shock waves will fragment the stones will propel out spontaneously through the normal passage from the ureter into the bladder. Now, this limitation of the extracorporeal shockwave lithotripsy is that it cannot be used when the stone size is more, because the stone fragments will be larger for them to pass through the normal urinary pipe. Secondly, it also depends on the density of the stone. Now, the density of the stone in a layman's word is the strength of the stone. Like you wattage, like a bulb has a wattage of 60, 80, 100. So the stone also has its power, and this power is being ascertained by CT, that is the computed tomography, which ascertains the Hounsfield units. The Hounsfield units is the strength of the stone which is being calibrated. Now, ESWL is not successful in stones which are more than 1000 HU, that is 1000 Hounsfield units. So you cannot offer this modality of a treatment in patients who have got kidney stones less than a centimeter with Hounsfield units of more than 1000. Also, another disadvantage of the extracorporeal shockwave lithotripsy is that during the shock waves, there occurs some damage to the kidneys because of these shock waves. Patient can have bleeding and there can be some nephron damage which is happening. So this is another demerit of ESWL. The only advantage being the patient feels that he is not undergoing a major procedure. It is a daycare procedure. It is an OPD procedure where the facility is available. So this was the first modality which I have explained, that is the ESWL.